शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोत्तम प्रवरं मुनीनां पतञ्जलिं प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि।
नमस्ते, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द योगा सेशन। In this session, we are going to use a chair, a mat, and a couple of blankets. We are going to focus on some stretch for the lower extremities combined with twisting postures. Before doing other postures, we will begin with some preliminary postures. For that, lie on your back, rest the legs on the chair, rest the complete trunk on the mat, keep an appropriate neck pad, keep both the palm on the abdominal cavity. As you inhale, the abdominal region has to expand, as you exhale it should contract. Watch the back muscles also, because of the position of the legs, the venous return, that is the impure blood flowing from the lower extremities to the heart, improves. The complete back muscles, because of the pelvic tilt, tend to relax better. But use your breath. Now right leg up, pull the kneecap, stretch the heel, toes towards the knee, kneecap towards the hip, tighten the upper thigh, the quadriceps, and breathe consciously. Watch the back muscles also. Right leg down, change, left leg up, stretch the heel, pull the kneecap, feel the stretch in the calf muscle and the hamstring muscles at the back of the thigh, feel the back muscles. In this posture, the lumbar region also rests very nicely on the mat, and use your breath to feel that region. Left leg down, one more time, right leg up, pull the kneecap, stretch the heel, stretching the toes towards the knee is very important, because that would stretch the Achilles tendon, which would further intensify the stretch on the calf muscle and the hamstring muscle group. With every inhalation and exhalation, you should feel the paraspinal muscles, especially the lower back, and the thick skin resting. That should also be felt. Right leg down, chain, left leg up. Pull the kneecap, stretch the heel. Tighten the upper thigh muscles, the quadriceps. Left leg down. Hold right leg, hold the knee, press the knee closer to the chest. Even here, you should stretch the heel, that is toes towards the knee, and tighten the back of the thigh, the hamstring, so that you can feel the complete knee capsule. And pull the knee closer to the chest. This is good for the gluteal muscles, also helps the back muscles to get a good stretch. Release right leg, chain, left leg, fold, hold the knee, press the knee to the chest. Feel the back muscles. As you inhale, the abdominal cavity should expand. As you exhale, it should contract. And this movement or the massaging effect of breathing has to be felt on the posterior surface, that is the lower back region resting on the mat. Release left leg. One more time, right leg, fold, hold the knee, press the knee closer to the chest. The thick skin on the lower back called the thoracolumbar fascia resting on the mat should also respond to the breathing and should feel that. So it is an important area of attention. Release right leg, chain, left leg, fold, hold the knee, press the knee close to the chest. The plane of the hip, knee, ankle, that is also important. You must pull it in the appropriate direction. And you should pull it hard against the abdomen so that good breathing nicely massages the intestinal organs. Release left leg. Now right leg up, fold from left hand, hold the ankle joint, pull the heel closer to the root of the left thigh. From right hand, push the knee. Watch your breathing. Tighten the hamstring muscles, that is the back of the thigh, and feel the knee capsule. Release right leg, chain, left leg. Hold from right hand, hold the ankle joint, pull it across the right thigh. From left hand, push the knee. So if possible, you can take the right heel to the left heel to the root of the right thigh. As you inhale and exhale, feel the base of the spine. Release left leg. One more time. Right leg up. Fold it across the left thigh. And push the knee. Tighten the hamstring muscles to the back of the thigh. This posture helps the hips, knee, and also the base of the spine. Release right leg. One more time, left leg. Left leg up, fold from right hand, hold the ankle joint, pull it across the right thigh, from left hand push the knee. This is especially good for the mobilization of the sacroiliac joint. That is the articulation between the spinal column and the hip bone. Release left leg. Relax the legs. Right leg up. Fold from left hand, hold the ankle joint, pull from right hand, push the knee across the chest. This is a good stretch for the gluteal maximus muscle. One of the major muscles in our system. Release right leg, chain, left leg up, fold from right hand, hold the ankle joint, pull it from left hand, push the knee across the chest. Ensure that the pelvic rim does not rotate off the mat. Watch your breathing. Breathe consciously. Feel the stretch in the gluteal region. Release left leg. One more time, right leg. Right leg up, fold from left hand, hold the ankle joint, pull from right hand, push the knee across the chest. You should keep the neck at the center and chin towards the chest. All these postures also greatly help the lower back. Release right leg, chain, left leg up, fold from right hand, hold the ankle joint, pull from left hand, push the knee across the chest. This is also good for the intestinal organs. Because of the nice massaging effect created by the pressure of the thigh against the abdomen. Feel the posture, get involved. Release left leg, relax. Fold right leg, taking the right heel just below the left knee. From left hand, pull the left thigh, from right hand push the right knee. Ensure that you stretch the heels. Toes should move towards the knee. Left heel at the edge of the chair. Release and relax. Hold left leg, taking the heel just below the right knee. From right hand, pull the right thigh, taking the right heel to the edge of the chair. From left hand, push the knee. Stretch both the heels, toes towards the knee. And tighten the hamstring muscles on both the legs. At the back of the thigh, that must be tightened. So feel the deep inside region of the hip. Release, relax both legs. One more time, hold right leg, taking the right ankle joint just below the knee. From left hand, pull the left leg, from right hand push the knee. Breathe well. This is very good for the deeper muscles of the hip. Also helps the lower back. Release the legs. Then chain, left leg, pull the right leg. From left hand, push the left knee. Watch your breathing. Watch the base of the spine. Watch deep inside the hip. Now release both the legs. Rest them on the chair. Slowly get up. Stand upright. Keep a chair in front about 2 feet away. Flex both the knees. Take your right foot against the leg of the chair. Hold it over the chair. Right leg straight, lift your left leg, rest the left foot on the seat of the chair. Pull the right kneecap, chest and navel up. Right leg absolutely straight. Look at the heel, the Achilles tendon, the gastrocnemius muscle, the hamstring muscle. They all get a very good stretch in this posture. Especially the calf muscle gets a very good stretch. Bring the left leg down, take the right leg back, stand in Tadasana, flex both the knees, take the left foot against the foot of the chair, hold the top of the chair, left leg straight. Rest the right foot on the chair. Chest and navel up. This is a good dorsiflexion for the foot, and that would engage the Achilles tendon, which would further intensify the stretch on the calf muscle, and that again intensifies the stretch on the hamstrings or the back of the thigh. The calf muscle, as you know, is called the second heart of the body. Therefore, this posture is very good for the calf muscle. Down. Stand upright in Tadasana. Now stand closer to the chair. Left leg up, left foot on the chair. Inhale, exhale, turn. Taking the right hand down. Right upper arm to the left knee and hold the junction of the chair from the right hand. Inhale, exhale, turn. Right leg straight. Stretch the spine, twist the spine. As you inhale, abdominal cavity should expand. As you exhale, it should contract. This is a simple twist in the standing stance. Very useful for the back muscles and also for the gluteal region. Also helps in invigorating the intestinal organs. Slowly come up, take your left leg down. You have to stand almost very close to the chair. Stand upright, right leg up. Rest the right foot on the seat of the chair. From right hand, push the left knee. Take the left hand down, taking the upper arm to the knee and holding the junction of the chair from the left hand. Right hand on the waistline. Inhale, exhale, ta. We'll open the chest, turn the right shoulder, stretch the spine. Watch your breathing. So this posture does help in greatly relieving the stiffness in the lower back. Watch your breathing. Do not hold the breath. Slowly come up. Take your right leg down. Stand upright. Slightly move back about a feet away, flex the knee, take the right foot against the leg of the chair, rise your left leg up, keep the left foot on the chair. Now combine the twisting with this. Take your right hand down, gripping the right upper arm to the left knee and holding the junction of the chair from right hand, left hand on the waistline, twist the trunk. So now this dorsiflexion of the foot is combined with the twist of the trunk. It's a hybrid posture. Breathe well. You can also appreciate the effectiveness of the chair in accomplishing these sorts of posture. Keep on twisting, keep on stretching. Slowly come up, bring the left leg down, stand in Tadasana, flex the knee, take the left foot against the leg of the chair, hold it out of the chair, rise your right leg up, right foot on the seat of the chair, chest and navel up, twist the trunk, lock the right knee from left upper arm, from left hand hold the junction of the chair, right hand on the waistline, inhale, exhale, turn the trunk. So combine that good stretch at the lower extremity with a good twist at the back. So doing these multivarious positions would engage all intricate muscle groups connecting the leg to the hip, hip to the back. So they are all in sort of a kinematic chain. Watch your breathing. Do not hold the breath. Twist the trunk. Twist the neck also in the direction of the twist. Slowly come up. Bring the right leg down. Stand upright in Tadasana. Stand about 2 feet away, stand in Tadasana, chest and navel up. Pull the kneecap, rise your right leg up, rest the right heel on top of the chair, stretch the toes towards the knee, pull the kneecap, tighten the quadriceps, gently tilt the trunk, hold the top of the chair from both hands. Push the root of the right thigh down and lift the trunk and navel up. Feel the stretch in the back of the thigh. Left leg absolutely straight. Mind the orientation of the left foot. Left foot should point towards the chair. Keep on pulling the kneecap. Both legs straight. Feel the stretch in the back of the thigh. For that you should stretch the heel, toes towards the knee. Tighten the quadriceps. Push the root of the right thigh down and lift the trunk and navel up. Look forward. Hamstring muscles get a good stretch here. Slowly come up, take the right leg down, change. Left leg up. Keep the left heel on top of the chair. Pull both the kneecaps gently. Tilt the trunk, hold the top of the chair. Pull the left toes towards the knee, kneecap towards the hip. Back of the thigh straight, chest and navel up. Keep on pulling both the kneecaps. Do not flex the trunk. You should keep the spine straight, lifted up. Do not hold the breath. Watch your breathing. Pay attention. Be present. Slowly come back. Stand upright in Tadasana. Right leg up again. Right heel on the seat of the chair. Stretch the heel, pull the kneecap. Gently tilt the trunk, hold the top of the chair. Inhale, exhale, turn. Keep the left hand fingertips on the seat of the chair next to the right ankle joint. Right hand on the waistline. Twist the trunk. Chest and navel up. Keep on pulling both the kneecaps. Push the root of the right thigh down. Stretch the trunk. Twist the trunk. Breathe well. This is very good for the hamstring muscles, the hips and the back. And all the muscles that connect them. Breathe well. Slowly come up. Hold the top of the chair. Bring the right leg down. Stand in Tadasana. Left leg up. Left heel on the seat of the chair. Stretch the heel. Toes towards the knee. Pull the kneecap. Tilt the trunk, hold the top of the chair, both legs straight. Now gently twist, taking the right hand down, right hand fingertips on the seat of the chair just next to the ankle joint. From left hand, hold the waistline and turn. We'll open the chest. Hamstring muscles have a very crucial role on the health of the lower back. So here is a posture which connect this intricate system. Breathe well. Slow inhalation, slow exhalation. All twisting movements have a positive impact on the intestinal organs. Slowly come down, hold it out of the chair, bring the left leg down, stand upright in Tadasana. Take a folded blanket, keep the blanket on the top rib of the chair, stand about 1 to 1.5 feet away from the chair, stand upright. Rise your right leg up, rest the right ankle on the blanket. Right leg straight, left leg straight. gently lean, hold the top of the chair, pull both the kneecaps. Right heel to be stretched, toes towards the knee. Pull the kneecap, tighten the quadricep muscles, push the root of the thigh down, lift the navel and trunk up. You can see that the degree of flexion at the hip increases in this posture, thus imparting a better stretch for the hamstring muscles. Slowly come down to Tadasana. Chain, left leg up. Rest the left ankle on the chair. Stretch the toes, pull the kneecap. Gently lean forward, hold the top of the chair. Both legs straight. Mind the orientation of the right foot. It should be properly aligned with the direction of the chair. It should not tilt. Keep on pulling the kneecap. You have to stretch the chest and navel up, push the left hip down, and experience the intense stretch of the back of the thigh. The calf muscle also gets a good stretch in this posture. The mobility, flexibility of the hips improve. While doing all these postures, ensure that you deeply focus on the muscles involved and on the breathing. Slowly come down, stand upright in Tadasana. Right leg up again, rest the right heel on top of the chair, flex the trunk, hold the top of the chair. Inhale, exhale, turn. Take your left hand down, locking the side rib of the chair and the right leg, right hand on the waistline, twist. We'll open the chest, pull the kneecap, push the root of the right thigh down. So right elbow to be turned, shoulder to be opened, left elbow to grip the right shin, left hand to hold the rib of the chair, both legs straight. Now to stretch the spine, twist the spine. Slowly come up, hold the top of the chair, take the right leg down, stand in Tadasana. Do on the left side, left leg up, left heel on the blanket, tilt the trunk, hold the top of the chair, stretch the heel, pull the kneecap, we'll open the chest. Gently twist the trunk from right hand, lock the shin bone and the side rib of the chair, left hand on the waistline, inhale, exhale, turn. Both legs straight. Push the root of the left thigh down and twist well. As we inhale, the abdominal cavity should expand, as we exhale, it should contract. That would help to invigorate the intestinal organs. Very important, a good stretch for the hamstring muscles superimposed with a nice twist for the trunk. Very useful for the lower back. Slowly come back, hold the top of the chair, bring the left leg down, stand upright in Tadasana. turn the chair, sit on your heel, knee on the blanket, take your right leg forward at 90 degrees, hold the top of the chair, inhale, exhale, sit square. Chest and navel up. Press the right foot. Stretch the left leg. Right leg in flexion. Left hip in extension. Feel the differential movement. Feel your lower back. Slowly come up. Take the knee back, knee to rest on the folded blanket. Take your left leg forward, left knee at 90 degree, hold the top of the chair, inhale, exhale, flex the left knee and sit. Ensure that the left foot is completely pressed. Note the direction of stretch of the right leg. The line and length should be properly maintained. Left calf and thigh should close in so that knee is completely flexed. Chest and navel up. The chair gives that sense of orientation, direction. Feel for the symmetry, makes the posture effective. One can stay longer. Slowly come up, take the left leg back, holding the top of the chair, take the right leg forward again. Inhale, exhale, sit square, chest and navel up. Inhale, exhale, turn. Taking the left hand down from the left upper arm, lock the right knee from left hand. Hold the leg of the chair from right hand, hold the top of the chair and twist. So right hip in flexion, left hip in extension, superimposed with a nice twist for the trunk. Breathe well. Slow inhalation, slow exhalation. Slowly come up. Take the right leg back, rest the right knee on the blanket. Left foot forward. Left leg bent at 90 degrees, inhale, exhale, sit square. Sit as much as possible, well open the chest, watch your back. Hold the top of the chair, chest and navel up. Then twist the trunk. Lock the left knee from right elbow. From right hand, hold the foot of the chair. From left hand, hold the top of the chair and twist. Feel the region of the tailbone, feel both the hips. A nice stretch and twist. Slowly come up, take your left leg back, sit on top of the heel, sit upright. Again, kneel down, hold the top of the chair. Chair should be about 2 feet away from the chair. Rise your right leg up, rest the right heel on the seat of the chair, chest and navel up, stretch the heel, pull the kneecap, push the root of the right thigh down, left leg still bent at 90 degrees, chest and navel up, hold the top of the chair to orient the chest properly, keep the left calf muscle active, stretch the left foot, squeeze the left calf muscle, feel the stretch in the right back of the thigh. Do not hold the breath. Always be attentive, have complete musculoskeletal awareness. Check your right leg down, change, left leg up, rest the left heel on the seat of the chair, stretch the left toes towards the knee, kneecap towards the hip, push the root of the left thigh, lift the navel and trunk up. As we inhale, the abdominal cavity should expand. As we exhale, it should contract. Watch the stretch in the back of the left thigh. Slowly bring the left leg down. One more time, right leg up, right heel on the seat of the chair, stretch the heel, pull the kneecap, well open the chest, gently lean forward. In leaning forward, you should actually tilt the trunk, not flex the trunk, well open the chest, taking the forehead to the top rib of the chair. You can flex the elbows, pull the kneecap, push the root of the right thigh down. So this provides a nice stretch for the muscles deep in the region of the hip. Left foot also to be stretched, left calf muscle to be tightened. Slowly come up, bring the right leg down. Chain, left leg up, left heel on the seat of the chair, stretch the heel, pull the kneecap, push the root of the left thigh down, chest and navel up. Inhale, exhale, bend forward without flexing the trunk. Keep on pulling the kneecap. Feel the stretch in the deeper muscles of the hip. Push the thigh, lift the trunk and navel up. That is when you get an intense stretch at the back of the thigh. Slowly come up, bring the left leg down. Right leg up. Now we are going to combine this forward tilt with this stretch and then twist. Hold the seat of the chair from the left hand, right hand on the waistline. Inhale, exhale, turn. Grip the chair from left hand, twist the trunk. Roll the right shoulder as far back as possible, opening the chest. Right leg absolutely straight, push the root of the right thigh down. Breathe well. slowly come up, holding the top of the chair, bring the right leg down, change, left leg up, left heel on the seat of the chair, pull the kneecap, stretch the heel, take the right hand down, from right hand hold the chair, left hand on the waistline, twist the trunk, pull open the left shoulder, the back of the thigh is intensely stretched, there is a twist of the trunk, there is a forward tilt, there is a stretch of the trunk, and breathe well. Hold the top of the chair, slowly come up, bring your left leg down, sit upright on your heels, sitting on the heels will greatly help the leg muscles to relax. Keep the blanket on top of the chair. Lie on your back close to the chair and take the legs up, resting the heel against the chair. Complete lower back to relax, neck at the center, chin towards the chest, spread both arms symmetrically, palm facing upwards, just relax the fingers. Don't need to stretch. Foot also can be relaxed. Because of the elevated position of the legs, the venous returns, that is the impure blood coming from the legs to the heart. Is going to improve. The legs relax because of the elevated position of the legs, owing to the tilt of the pelvis, the complete lumbar region nicely sits or meshes with the mat. Complete back is relaxed, legs relaxed, arms relaxed, eyes gently closed. As we inhale, the abdominal cavity should expand, as we exhale, it should contract. So when you do this, even the posterior region, the thick skin around the lumbar and thoracic area, the thoracolumbar fascia, that also responds to breathing. In the sense, as we inhale, you can feel a stretch in that region, and as you exhale, they again flex back to their original pay attention. You have to breathe slowly, steadily. Ideally, the exhalation should be longer than the inhalation. should completely be involved. Just watch. Just pay attention to your breathing. This elevated leg position. Helps the legs to relax. It also facilitates the back to relax. Bring both legs down. Slowly get up from the right side. Sit upright in the cross-legged posture. Now we are going to do a basic technique to understand and improve our ability for sustained attention. We are going to count from 50 to 1 in the descending order. This has to be done mentally without moving the tongue or the lips. Internally you have to count, and in between the counts there should be a gap of about 3 seconds. That is, start with 50, 49, 48, more or less in that speed. Don't be in a hurry, be calm. You can start now. You are counting from 50 to 1. As you are doing, see what is happening in between. Is your mind focused? Are you able to keep track of the counting? Is the mind too distracted and not able to count? Or you are able to count, but still the mind wanders rapidly? You are missing counts, yeah, but you are able to come back to counting. Just watch. This is a simple test to get a brief about the status of our mind. Focus on your counting. Mind is generally very turbulent in nature. It can get stuck somewhere. You are not able to move away from that. That is the kshipta avastha. It can oscillate. Sometimes you are able to focus. Suddenly you lose the focus, the mind takes you somewhere. Again you are back, again you are going. So it can be oscillatory vikshipta avastha. Sometimes it does not allow you to do anything. A lot of tamas. You feel drowsy, sleepiness, confused, mudha avastha. If you can be focused on the counting, hold the attention on the counting, even in the gaps of the counting, the mind is able to be there. That is ekagratavastha. By now you should have counted. Just check a look at what really happened. What was the state of your mind? Make a self-assessment. These are all techniques to improve the focus. Namaste.